Hey y'all, it's KaylaJ here. So I know it's been a long time. I'm so sorry, but a lot has been going on in this month. So I actually just moved into a house. God bought me a house, y'all. And it's just so crazy. This is really quick before I get in the video, but it's just so crazy because I've always been thinking like, okay, I have to wait until this person comes into my life. And then that's when this will happen and that'll happen. And God is just showing me like, it's always just been you and me. Like, this man will be an asset to your life, but he's not going to provide you anything that I can't provide you. So God is just really just, even with the spirit of fear, I struggle with that a lot. And I thought, I don't want to move into a house by myself. And God has just shown me it has always just been you and me. You will be good. And so I'm just really grateful to God, just showing me, like, financially, he's got me. I'm thinking as a teacher, you know, y'all know teachers don't make much, but like, I'm thinking like, okay, I have to wait because for an additional income, but God's just like, girl, if you don't trust me, like I have showed you before that I take care of you better than any man could. And so, man, God is just so good, y'all. If you're believing for anything just that's out of your realm financially or what normal people aren't doing, just believe, y'all, and God will show up and show out. It's no way I should have gotten this house, but here I am. And also, forgive me, the blinds don't come in until March, so I know it's a little. Anyways, so I'm gonna edit this piece, this clip, into a video that I actually made in November. All right, so a little backstory, y'all. God told me I would be married. I know in the series, God told me who my husband is. Like I did like 6-7 parts. I know that it kind of seemed like I was alluding to something happening in December. And that's because I was, in December, 2020, God told me that I would be married December 4th, 2021. I know. So the clip that you're about to see is like a long video explaining how God told me, how it came about, and the end of it is just me like in faith saying it's gonna happen still. Yeah, let's get into it. Yeah, baby. It's part of a purpose, guys. Promise of a good. Hey y'all, KaylaJ here. So today, first of all, let me pray because this is really heavy, as you probably saw in the title, but let me just say a prayer really quick. God, I thank you for everything you've done, everything you're going to continue to do, Lord. I want to be honest, Lord God, and I want to be open. Holy Spirit, speak through me, Holy Spirit. Your people have tuned into this message because they are expecting from you, because you have promised them something, Lord God, because they heard something from you and they're trying to discern what it is, Lord God. So I hope that I can be of help, Lord God. Take me out of it. Minimize me. Minimize my situation, Lord God. Allow them to see their situation through my words. Allow them to see how you're going to come through for them and you're going to do what you said you would do for them, Lord God. So I just thank you right now for the person listening to this, Lord God. I thank you that you're giving them their joy and their peace and their hope back, Lord God. You're giving them their hope back, Lord God. They're going to be able to have faith in you that you are the God who does exactly what you say you're going to do. So we just thank you, Lord God. We ask that you forgive us of our sins. And we just ask that you just continue to work on the inside of us, in our waiting, in our time of testing and trial, Lord God. And so in your name we pray. Amen. Okay. So I made a video, I think in May. And the video is entitled, God Told Me Who My Husband Is, Crazy or Just Plain Crazy or Crazy Faith. So since May, let me just start by saying I've gotten a lot of comment. Well, okay, let me not trip. I only got like 22 comments, but for me, it's a lot because I usually never get any. And a lot of people have viewed the video. And it truly shows me that God's people are wanting to know, is there anybody else who's in this? Because I know for me, I truly feel like I'm alone, you know? I feel like I'm out here in the deep by myself. I know, of course, God is with me here, but I truly just sometimes feel like my flesh feels like it's just me. I know God has been 10 toes down since the beginning, but I just feel like it's me. And then I put that video out and a lot of you saying, oh my gosh, God told me this, God told me this. And yeah, it's just, it's really great to know that I'm not in this alone. And I want you to know that you're not in this alone. I didn't know God was telling people who their spouses were, revealing whole names, identities, revealing birthmarks, revealing lineage, revealing just all this stuff. And it's like, oh my gosh, revealing dates to people they've never even met before. I thought it was just me. And so it makes me feel really good to know that it's not just me. But on the other hand, oh, this other hand, okay? A lot of y'all are really just, if you don't have the faith to believe this will happen to you, why are you gonna sow doubt onto other people? Like, I've had people not only in the comments, but message me like, what you're believing for is witchcraft. You shouldn't covet another. Cause I think maybe they saw 2 seconds of the last video and concluded that I'm over here praying for his relationships to fail when that's not the case. I literally said, I'm praying for him that she is conducive to what he needs when he comes to me, you know? And so just terrible things. And for a while, I felt like I needed to turn the comments off because, man, when you're in a season, I guess like I'm in, or like you're watching this, if you're in the, if somebody says the slightest thing, depending on how your day is going, it's like, you're just on the floor, just, oh my God, God, you're not gonna do it. Like when I say every other day, I like fall to my knees and I'm like, God, this is a sick joke that you've been playing on me since 2016. This is very sick and I don't appreciate it. And then on other days I'm like, God, I thank you. What do you want me to do today to show you that I believe you, that to show you that it's gonna happen, blah, blah, blah. So yeah. Be careful the words that you put on somebody. You don't know what type of mindset they're in. You don't know. And you don't know what God told them. Maybe it didn't happen for you, but don't spit that bitterness on someone else. And if you do feel like that person is on the wrong path, rather than leaving a semi-hateful comment, maybe just pray for them. Like, I know for me, I was doing something today and I was in an exercise class and we were doing a stretch, and the way she wanted us, this is with a lot of older ladies, the way she wanted us to do it, I was like, I think this is going to hurt some of their backs. Like, what is she doing? And I was like, no, it wouldn't be my place to go up to her. We don't have that relationship to go up to her and say, hey, you're going to break these women's backs because of the way you want us to like do this exercise. But I was like, God, I ask that you reveal to her the proper way to do it. If this, maybe I'm wrong too, but if I'm not, reveal the proper way for her to do this exercise. Does that make sense? So like, I say that to say like, God will talk to that person and ask God to give them a fresh revelation. Don't comment something ugly and, or something bitter on something that you don't know. Because then you're messing with what God has already spoken. You're messing with that. You're messing with that person's head. And so that could possibly come back on you too. So if the person is way out of left field and it's just like, no, baby, you need to go talk to God again. Talk to God and ask God to send them a revelation. Be the blessing. Sow encouragement. Because I'm sick of it. I can't take another comment of somebody just, or a message of somebody like sowing doubt where I'm already doubting myself. So yeah, but God revealed to me December 4th, what's I say, 1999, December 4th, 2020, oh my gosh, 2020. December 4th, 2020, God revealed to me that would be my wedding date. A little backstory. So I had just come from my father's for Thanksgiving. My father and my mother are now divorced. And it was a few years in the making, so people thought it was inevitable, but I felt like, no, God, like, they're going to push, you know? And it didn't happen. I've always prayed against generational curses on my family, and that was one that I was always at the top, no divorce. And for that to happen, it really, like, rocked me, you know? Like, man, is that going to be my portion? Is that my brother and sister's portion to have divorce? You know, after 30 years going strong, really did do something to me. And so my dad is now remarried. And God told me to, my church was in a forgiveness sermon. And so God told me, he said, I want you to, or in the sermon, he was just like, God, he said something. And I know he was looking right at the camera. And so I really felt like he was talking to me. And I know through the spirit he was like, go back. I know you don't want to, but go back, because when you go back this time, that's when you'll be healed of the forgiveness. That's when the forgiveness is going to work in your life. And so I went the previous Thanksgiving and it sucked. And I was just like, God, I'm here because I don't want to grow bitter towards my father. That's the only reason I'm here, because I know life is not promised. And then when God asked me to go back the next year, I was already making other plans. God asked me to go back the next year. He said, you don't have to do this. It's not an obedience test. But I want you to do this because I know this man coming into my life is a direct correlation of my relationship with my father. I know that's not everybody's story. And so I don't want you to think that that's your story too. But like, I just know if I don't have forgiveness in my heart for my father, then I just feel like it won't be any room for him. And when he comes, he's going to have to deal with these daddy issues that I don't want him to deal with. And so I know God is speaking to me in the area of forgiveness of my father. And so I went for Thanksgiving. I was like, okay, God, I'm here, you know, got back. A couple of days later, I just felt God saying like, you did what I asked you to do. And I'm so pleased, y'all. December 4th, 2020, I was writing in my journal that morning, and then I got a call from my aunt. We were just talking casually, and she was like, oh yeah, today would be the 73rd wedding anniversary of your grandparents. They got married on December 4th. And I was like, wow, that's really beautiful. Because I mean, I guess I knew that, but then I just forgot that I knew that. They got married in 1947. So I think she said 73rd. And then like, we got off the phone and it just stuck with me. I was like, wow, wouldn't that be beautiful? I'm like a really family oriented person. Like, I love traditions. I love history. And to honor my ancestors, to honor the past is just something I live to do. Like, I can't wait to do that, however, in my career. And I was like, wow, wouldn't that be amazing if I got married on December 4th? Holy Spirit, that I truly feel like that was a Holy Spirit statement. So I kind of pushed it to the back of my mind. I was like, girl, you tripping. You don't even know this man. And you're trying to plan wedding dates. So then I got a call from my mom. I was happy, you know. I got a call from my mom. She was like, yeah, I just got the papers in. The divorce is finalized. I was like, man, like, I knew it was coming, but I just thought, any day now they're going to say, you know what, let's give it, you know, just that, I don't even want to say childish hope, just that hope, that childlike hope that God asked us to have. I thought, you know, maybe. It didn't happen. And so my mom called me and she was like, yeah, December 4th, 2020, it's official. We're divorced. You know, of course she wasn't happy. She like, you know, she wasn't sad. She wasn't happy. It had been a long time coming. She had peace about it. And I hung up the phone. I was kind of sad. And then I started writing in my journal and God was just like, that's your wedding date, December 4th. I was like, oh my gosh, here I go talking to myself again. And I doubt the Holy Spirit every time. I know it's the Holy Spirit, but I act like it's not. I act like, oh, what was that? Like, you know, baby girl, that was the Holy Spirit. So anyways, God said it. I got the confirmation from my aunt. I got the confirmation from, you know, my parent. I was like, no, that ain't it. And so I wrote it down because I know I have enough sense to know that if I even think it's the Holy Spirit, to write it down. So I wrote it down and went about my day. I thought about it for a while. And so then on December 5th, 2020, I had the courage to, when I was talking to one of my friends, I was like, and she knows, you know, this whole journey that I've been going through. I was like, like I whispered, I was like, I think, like, because I kept thinking about that whole day. And then the next day, I was like, I think God is trying to tell me that I'm going to get married on December 4th, 2021. And she was like, oh my, and guys, be careful who you talk to. They can literally kill your dreams in that moment, kill the faith in that split second you tell them, or they can uplift it and they can affirm it and encourage it and say, I don't know, but I'm going to pray with you, you know? Man, I told her and she was like, if you think that's the Holy Spirit, you need to like pray about that. And you need to look into accepting that and receiving that if you think this might be God telling you this. And then our phone call ended and I thought about it some more. So then December 6th, I was talking to God and I really felt like he was like, that's it. That's your wedding date. December 4th, 2021. And God was saying, I wrote down what he was saying. He was like, I really wish you would have believed me on December 4th. He was just like, I wish I would have brought my journal so I could read it verbatim. But he was just like, you could have received this prophecy December 4th, but you didn't believe. And now you're receiving it 2 days later. And I just kind of felt God's disappointment in, why don't you believe me yet? When I speak, why don't you believe me? You know, that was kind of like, man, you know, I could have had this 2 days before. So then I would like, usually I go through a process of, okay, I got to build my faith up around it. But like, as soon as God told me that, I was like, okay, my faith is up. God, I believe you. You said this is going to happen December 4th. I have a year to prepare. Okay, but when is he coming? So why December 4th? So God specifically told me that the enemy thinks he won. On December 4th, God said that Satan thinks that he can now be unleashed in our lineage, in my family's lineage, in the area of divorce. And God said that it's not so. God said that I will use where the enemy thinks he has won to step on his neck and to show him he has not won. And I will use what is the nucleus of your family's greatest pain, and I will make it into something that is beautiful. Beauty for ashes. And so God was just saying, like, I need you to get married on December 4th, a year later, because this is reversing the curse that the enemy thinks that he has over your family, over your lineage. And he needs to know that it ends with you. And so, yes, it has to be December 4th. I've never imagined a December wedding date. I always wanted to get married like May or something, where it's warm, for the aesthetics. But God needs this to happen. And at this point, you know, I think that's when you're younger. But when you start to realize that marriage is, gosh, it's about your purpose aligned. It's about what we're about to do for the kingdom together. You realize that stuff isn't important, when in the aesthetics. And, oh, I'm going to do that anyways, because I think I really want to have another wedding. Or not another wedding, but, like, I want to have a ceremony. But you realize that it's not important, but the actual marriage is important, not the wedding. And so December 4th it is. And then I, you know, started telling a few of my close friends, and they're like, wow, you know, because a year out, anything can happen in a year. They're like, wow, you know, we're standing with you, we believe it, blah blah blah. And then I got the courage to tell my sister. I wish I knew the date. It was like maybe towards the spring, summer, so anywhere from April to like June-ish something. I told her and she was like, oh my gosh, I'm taking my leave now. And so that really encouraged me, because I didn't know how she would meet me, like with faith or with doubt, because I'm still like, okay God, you told me last December. And I think when I told her, like I said, it was like spring or something, I was like, okay, now we're 6 months out, I guess I can do a romance in 6 months, you know, I guess that's possible. So on this journey, it's been really tough, because when God gives you a date like that and you don't kind of see any evidence, you start like wondering, like, okay, I know I heard God. And so I'm grateful that I haven't started to doubt. if he actually spoke it. I'm grateful that I'm just doubting the promise. I'm just doubting, like, okay, God, did I do something to make you want to change your mind? That's what I'm doubting. But I'm not doubting that he spoke it. And I thank God for that. But yeah, it's November. I don't have my watch. It's November 6th, I think. And I don't know him still. Yeah. And so now I'm just kind of like, Lord, did you really say that? And like that doubt is coming, because I went through a phase of, okay, God, like, I don't know, like, God, did you say that? Or is it something I did to change your prophecy, like in your promise? Like, so I know a generational curse, and there's a generational curse in my life that I know God wants to work out of. And I know God is saying, you cannot pass this on to your children. The spirit of lust, I'm just going to be transparent. The spirit of lust, God is saying, you cannot pass this down to your children. Even though, yes, like, I've been saving myself for marriage, but people get it twisted. Like, lust just is not about sex. It's about your mind, and it's about your thoughts. The Bible says, as a man thinketh. And so God is like, you're no better, you know, like, and God has really humbled me. Like, please don't ever put yourself above anyone else. You're no better, as a man thinketh. And so God has really been working in my area, in my life, in the area of lust. And like, you cannot pass this down to your children. You have enough sense to come and seek me. What if they don't? What if they just let lust run rampant in their lives? And so I know that God is working in that area, and I feel like I've truly failed over and over and over again. And so I thought, okay, God, you know, it's, this was like in maybe August. I was like, God, it's August and, you know, it hasn't happened. So maybe I failed you in the area of lust, and maybe that's why you're not going to bring him to me, on December 4th. And that, and then God really spoke to me. He was just like, it's not that. It's not that, yes, you haven't really dealt with it, and so you're going to have a harder time in marriage and with your children if you don't. But that's not it. That's not the case. And okay, so another backstory and just more and more confirmation. So after December 5th, when I talked to my friend, she texted me, I think, December 6th, right when I like received it. And I think maybe before, and that helped me to receive it even more. She texted me and she was just like, do you realize 12/4/21 is a mirror date? Like, she was just like, if you write it backwards, it's still 12/4/21. And she found, oh my gosh, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm going to put it on the screen. I think it's Proverbs, maybe. I don't want to guess. But I'm going to put it on the screen. Talked about being a wife and just all that confirmation. It was just really beautiful. And so that really helped, you know, in December when I was really like, okay, God, this is what you said. But yeah, so fast forward to August, I'm like, God, okay, it's something I did. Once he cleared that up, he told me it was nothing you did. I was like, okay, we're good. Then, I mean, I guess fast forward to like September, every month is a new battle. Every month is doubt. I'm just kind of like, okay, God, did you change your mind? Like, and people keep asking me, or not people, I guess a couple of people ask me, like, did you really hear God say 2021 or like another year? I'm just like, 2021, that's what I heard. And I'm at a point where, yes, I want to meet him, but it's not even about him anymore. It's about God making a promise to me and God seeing that promise through. Like, yes, I want to be married. Yes, I want to meet him, but this is about something I heard from God manifesting through God, you know, bump him. But what about my relationship with God? Because I'm so fearful that, you know, what if it doesn't happen? And I don't want to blame God. But then I can't even think like that. So I can't go there. I can't go there. So let me get back on track. So yeah, just really asking God, okay, what is it? Why isn't he here? And then recently God has just revealed like that Okay, so my pastor, he did a sermon, y'all. Oh my God. I might even link it because it blew me away. And I feel like if you have the faith to receive it, these words that he said, because every word is not for you, every sermon is not for you, but if you have the faith to believe it, then I truly feel like the words will attach themselves to you and God will come and bless you because you have the faith to believe it. So he preached a sermon called Bamboo Season, Unusual Acceleration. A little backstory. When I was in college, my young adult pastor, we came back from Christmas break one year and he was like, okay, y'all, God has given me a word for this house. I want you to receive it. I want you to pray about it. He was like, accelerated manifestation. Basically, he was just like, the things that take other people years to do, years to accomplish, it's not going to take you that long. He was like, it's a spirit of acceleration on you all. He was like, the Holy Spirit wanted me to specifically preach this message to this young adult crowd. It's a spirit of accelerated manifestation. And when I say, y'all, I have seen it in my life, like, just... maybe I have to make another video about that just to explain everything that I've seen and the evidence I've seen about it. But just things that would normally take people so long to accomplish, I have been able to accomplish them. And not even that, just things with my family, because I truly believe he's like, this word is attached to you and everybody surrounded with you. And I've definitely seen it in my family's life, especially my sister. I've seen it on her life where things happen so fast for her. And she's like, what is this? You know, what is this? So for Pastor Mike to preach it last Sunday when I was already like, Lord, it's November 1st is tomorrow. Like, I'm kind of done at this point. For him to preach that really blew me away. He was just like, it's a spirit of unusual acceleration. He was like, things are going to happen for you in this season that are going to be unusually fast. Like, it's going to be unusually speedy. And so he used the analogy of a bamboo plant, a bamboo tree. So he was just saying how, you know, you plant a bamboo tree and it's in the ground for like 3 years and it's like, okay, this thing isn't going to grow. What's going on? It looks dead. And so he was just saying, like, year three, the bamboo tree starts to grow at an exponential rate. My spirit just caught it immediately. He was just like, that's the spirit that I believe is on us this season. And just for him to preach that, and I've already been wondering, like, God, are you going to do this in a month? Y'all, it's November 6th. And I'm just thinking, like, how is God going to do this? But one of my friends gave me a great word of encouragement. She was just like, you don't stop believing until December 4th. And even other people, or my sister, have said, like, even after that, don't stop believing if it doesn't happen. And so the Lord got until December 4th with me, honestly. After December 4th. But I can't even go there. I can't even go there. And I'm already low-key making plans. And this is when I'm like on the sad days. I'm like, you know what? I think I'm gonna just book a trip to Jamaica because I would rather cry on the beach rather than crying in my bed. Somebody messaged me tried to shoot their shot on LinkedIn. They were like, I think we can definitely connect professionally if you would just reach back out to me, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, you're an engineer. How can we possibly connect professionally? So if December 4th doesn't happen, we will connect professionally. But then again, I'm like, Kayla, don't even go there. Like, don't even think like that. That's not conducive to what God wants to do. But yeah, so I just hear God saying, like, and I even ask God, I'm like, God, you know how to speak to me. Just tell me and I will stop having hope that December 4th will happen. Like, why would you still continue to make me hope that it's going to happen? Just tell me, you know? And he literally said, keep believing, keep trusting me. And it's just like, I know this is the area that's going to be my greatest miracle. And that's on my good days, y'all. I cannot lie. Like I said, some days I'm on the floor like, why, God? Why have thou forsaken me? Why would you play this sick joke on me, you know? So I can't lie like I'm not, like I'm okay every day or even every minute, you know? Ugh, gosh, but I get so many confirmations. Like I remember one time I talked with my friend, the same friend that was giving me the verses, and she was like, you know, the mirror date, 12/4/21. She's been receiving prophecy in this area as well and just been so vital. And another one of my friends, she has received prophecy as it relates to God revealing who her husband is. So I do feel like God puts you in mirrored seasons with people who are close to you in proximity, because he knows it's really tough if you're going through it alone. And so like, I just keep in mind who you talk to and who you're sharing this with, because people will try to kill it if they don't have the faith to believe it. But yeah, God has just been telling me not to give up. And okay, on November 1st, I felt like that's when I would have met him, because I felt like that's what God was saying. But I realized God never said that. He never said we would meet on December 1st. He said something would happen on December 1st. Was something happening in the spiritual or the natural. Of course, in the spiritual, we really won't know until it manifests. And so I really think something happened in the spiritual. I just don't know what it was. But I was disappointed on the 1st because I was like, God, I thought you said it would happen. And so realizing that sometimes we get upset with God because of something that we heard and something that we fabricated. Like I made up. God said November 1st, but he didn't say what would happen. I made that up. And so I just want to share with y'all, like, get confirmation. Like God has been confirming it and confirming it. And so pray that God confirms this for you, because sometimes our mind does play tricks on us, but have the faith to believe it. Don't let nobody ruin your faith or discourage you. But yeah, like after we talked on the phone, my friend and I, from my favorite restaurant, Chipotle, I saw a message and they gave me a coupon out of nowhere. And the coupon expires December 4th. Just so many things. I'll be scrolling the other day. Maybe, I think it was December 1st, actually. I was scrolling on Instagram, kind of feeling defeated. Like, God, you said. And why, back to back, it said Lizzo was doing something. Registration date, December 4th. Lifetime movie that I wanted to watch, December 4th. The next one after that, it said, your season is about to shift from single to married. Oh my gosh. And then the next one said, like, in your waiting, you're not alone, blah, blah, blah. And then one of my friends sent a text about her child's birthday party, registration or RSVP deadline, December 4th. Just so many confirmations over and over and over again. And so I do encourage you guys to get some confirmations from God. So yeah. Here lately, on November 4th, a month out, I've been talking to God. My sister encouraged me. She was like, you need to be talking to God every day. If you expect this to happen in a month, you need to be talking to God every day. Because I truly feel like being close to God, you hear his instructions. He says, go left. He says, do this instead of doing that, you know? And that's where I need to be in this season, to hear from the Holy Spirit. And so I haven't been. And so God encouraged me to not fast, but fast from different things that were taking my distraction, my attention away from him and distracting me. So it's not a mandatory fast, because I was like, God, I don't know about y'all, but I do not like fasting. I know it's amazing for you and it's been amazing for me, but oh my gosh. And so I was like, God asked me to fast in September. I did a 3-day water fast, just water, for the week. And after I finished the fast, I felt so good. And God was like, this is what I required of you, and you've done it. And just like, you know, well done. And then a couple of days later, God was just like, if you want to do it again, I definitely think you should, so you can get more focus and talk to me more. It's not what I require of you. You don't have to. It's not you being disobedient if you don't. And so I was like, well, you know, when God say that, you might as well do it. And so I did it another week, 3 days, just water. And that was amazing. And so, like, I just know that God was saying, like, this is great, you know. And so I didn't fast anymore after that. And so on Monday, when he was just like, on the 4th, when he was like, yeah, you should probably do something. I'm like, God, you don't remember September? Because I do. And so he was just like, you know, it doesn't have to be something like that, but just something that does not distract you from me. And so I decided to give up TV, which, oh my gosh, like I love corny Lifetime Christmas movies. Sucks. But I mean, my sister was like, this is your lifetime. So are you going to give this up? Or, you know, so I'm giving that up. Social media, secular music, sweets, sweet sugary drinks, bread, giving it up because I really need to hear from God. I need to be close to his ear for instruction, his mouth for instructions. So yeah, it's been a little tough. I already failed, but it's okay. As long as I'm actively trying to seek God and forgo any distractions, you know I'm good. Lastly, prepare. So I know in my heart that God is just encouraging me to continue to prepare. So what does that look like? I'm in a one bedroom / really big office that could be another bedroom apartment. And I wish I would have wrote down these dates, y'all. When God tells you something, write it down, date it, because he is not a man that lies. And so you can go back and say, God, when you go back and tell God what he said, I feel like God is like, oh, my bad, I gotta do it now, you know? And so write it down. But I woke up crying in the middle of the night. This was maybe in September, mid-September. And I was like, God, you're not gonna do this, are you? And God was just like, Lord, when I say the Lord is my calm in the storm, I'm the storm, if you didn't know. God is like literally the calm, the tranquility that I need. I woke up hysterical, crying, and God was just like, prepare, Kayla. And so 3 a.m., maybe it was 4 a.m., I got my notepad, I went around the house, and I started writing things down that I need to do. So for example, maybe I'll try to include some pictures. I cleaned out the bottom of the bathroom sink. I left him just a little space. I left him a space under the bathroom sink. I have an ottoman. I have like books and stuff in it. I cleaned out half of that, left him some space. I cleaned out, so I have another closet in here. That's why it could kind of be a bedroom. I have another closet in here where I have my jackets. Clean that out. The closet is clear. Oh, y'all, the Lord is telling me to clean out my coffee table so that way it could be his. Or my bedside table. I'm like, you know, okay. That's why I know, Lord, when we get married, are you going to bless us with a house immediately? Because I don't even have enough space in this apartment. Anyways, so yeah, the Lord is telling me to prepare in so many ways, even financially, y'all. I've been like making all my irresponsible purchases because I know like when I have someone to answer to, and not even in that like what the world says submission is, but truly in that we are a team and, you know, we both need to be responsible because we have goals. In type of way. And so I've been making like irresponsible purchases and I'm like, okay, you know, after December, you need to like tighten up. And even now I'm trying to tighten up too, like doing better with financially with a stewarding over my money. Yeah. So I've really just been preparing because I know God is telling me that so I won't be overwhelmed. So that way when we do meet, because at this point, y'all, it's looking like, oh my God, I'm even like afraid to say it. It's looking like we're gonna meet in like 2 weeks and be married. WTF. So, and I'm kind of wondering, I feel like I don't have an exact answer as to why, God, but I'm just like, I feel like, first of all, I know that this is for other people. I know that God doesn't bless you for you. Of course you, it's like, two birds with one stone, you do get blessed, but he blesses you so other people can see what he does and see how he, you know, see how amazing he is. And so, yeah, I know that this is for other people. And so I've even been like afraid. I've been like talking to my sister, like people are going to think I'm pregnant. People are going to, and you know, bump them, you know, or people are going to think, you know, like this is a scam. You know, I don't know. But just craziness. And I'm just like, God, why would you do this? And okay, people keep asking, and I keep saying people because only a few people know. My sister and my friends keep asking, like, would you be okay with just dating him and y'all meeting on December 4th? I would, that would be a dream. It would be a dream if we could just meet on December 4th and start dating. But every time I feel like I agree to that, with my flesh, talking to my friends, my sister, I feel a conviction from the Holy Spirit saying, well, then that's not my promise. And my promise is not perfect. Because God said, December 4th, 2021, you will be married to this man whom I've showed you, revealed to you in 2016. That's what God has said. And so I know that if we are just dating on December 4th, then that's not God's prophecy. Something, I don't know. And that's what's scary. Like, who's this voice I've been listening to this whole time if that doesn't happen, you know? That's why I have no choice but to believe. I know I'm 27 days out. But I have no choice but to believe that this was God, because he's shown me too many confirmations, one. And it's just like, I literally cannot go down that avenue of who else, who was this. I can't. So I have no choice but to believe it's God. And so, yeah, it's just a mess. But I know that this is for other people. I know this is God showing them that this is unusual acceleration. And I also know I'm preparing myself too, because I'm like, baby girl, it's not going to be sunshine and rainbows. You're literally merging your life with somebody in a matter of weeks. You know, my favorite show is Married at First Sight. I'm kind of like, oh my God, I'm getting married at first sight. Not technically, but you know, low key. But yeah, so I know that my real work starts December 4th. And which is kind of scary, because when I say this has been so hard, I feel like I'm truly on an incline up a mountain, trying to get to December 4th, believing that God is still going to do this for me. So to think that this is not even the pinnacle of difficulty, that being married is tough, and sharing my life with someone and continuing in ministry. My ministry is about to double. Like, not only do I have to be a good wife, but I'm supposed to be doing my, you know, in my purpose, doing things in the community. Like, yeah, so I just keep reminding myself, it's not going to be sunshine and rainbows. It's going to be hard work. You need to get ready. So yeah, God is going to do it. I stand here on November 6th, 27 days away from December 4th. Oh my God, it's November 6th. And God told me, you know, I received it on December 6th. That's a year ago. Wow. Thank you, Lord. I will be married on December 4th. That's so crazy. Anyways, so yeah, I will be married. And God is just telling me, don't worry. Like, I'm like, what if his parents don't like me? What if they think, like, this is outrageous? And I know they are. What if my parents are tripping? But honestly, I'm not really worried about my parents. Because when you do enough crazy faith stuff, you start to get, like, street cred, you know? Like, I moved to Oklahoma because God told me to move here. I literally had the moving company come and pack up my stuff like December 17th. Hadn't received a job offer yet. Did not have an apartment secured yet because I hadn't received a job offer. My sister literally like, what are you doing? This girl is crazy. The moving company showed me favor. They were like, man, we really need an address. We have your stuff, but we need an address before January, the drop-off date. I was like, okay, I'm going to get you the address maybe after Christmas. Crazy. But I know God told me that I'm supposed to be in Oklahoma, and I know he said he would provide. He provided. God told me to give away my car. I gave away my car for free. Went without a car in a new city for 5 months because God told me to do it. Fifth month, someone calls me, and they're like, I don't know, but God told me to give you my car, so I'm going to send the car. And he told me to do it in a month. I needed the car literally after the month ended. They sent the car. Everything was free to me. Jesus. It's crazy. It's crazy until it happens, and then people consider it faith. And so this is crazy until it happens, and then people are going to say, she had faith. but it's crazy right now, and they judge me right now, and it's tough right now, but it's crazy until it manifests. So I'm praying that my parents and my family are like, you know what, we believe her. We believe she's not just haphazardly entering into a marriage. We believe that she is, you know, she's thought through this, and we trust her decision. And so that's what I'm praying that my family gives me, because I really need it. I'm also praying, if they don't, that my heart and my emotions aren't fragile, and I will be bold and say, okay. Yeah, but I can't worry about that. This is mandate from God. Like I said, I'm gonna be fine just dating him, but that's not God's mandate. And if it's not perfect, then I don't want it either. And I know God doesn't want it, because he's perfect. His plans are perfect. He said. So yeah. Well, I pray that y'all continue to follow me on this journey to December 4th, because it's been rough. But yeah, thank y'all for rocking with me. I'm believing. If you're watching this, you've gotten your confirmations, because I can't condone. I'm not trying to be a YouTube troll, but I can't condone what God hasn't put a stamp on. So if you're just believing this because you feel like this person is supposed to be, because I told y'all in the last video, I wanted to marry that guy in my English class who was just scrumdiddlyumptious. But this man is tied to my purpose. This man is tied to my destiny. And I'm gonna love him, and we're gonna make a beautiful life together. And so it's not from what you want, it's from what you need. I need him, he needs me. So yeah, I cannot condone what God hasn't put a stamp on. So if you just feel, then this message is not for you. But if you know in your heart and you've gotten confirmations from God that this is what he said, then I'm believing with you, and we will see God's promise come to pass in this earth. Yes. So I pray the Lord blesses you. I pray he keeps you. I pray he keeps you from the enemy and all his doubt. And I pray that you're in a nice cocoon where your faith can be grown. Yeah, that's what I pray. Love you guys. Please comment, like, share, subscribe. Bye, y'all. So this is a visual reminder for me. It's on my lock screen on my phone just to keep moving forward. This is the connectivity between my grandparents married 1947, December 4th, and my parents divorce 2020, December 4th. And of course, what God has promised me December 4th, 2021, between me and my future spouse and our marriage, because I already see spiritual warfare that is trying to stop this in its tracks. And so this is just to encourage me to keep going as my faith grows. It's probably a purpose, guys. Promise.